Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 11 comes out tomorrow, or it may already be out by the time you're watching this video. Either way, I wanted to help you prepare and make sure your phone is ready to upgrade to the newest version. So the first thing you need to know are the different models that are supported. So on the iPhone side, that means iPhone 5S and newer. So iPhone 5S, SE, and then newer than that. So the 5C and the 5 are not supported, and anything older than that is also not supported. On the iPad side, iPad mini 2, 3, and 4 are supported. The fifth generation iPad and newer basically are supported. So if you have an iPad 1, 2, or third generation, or fourth generation iPad, it may not be supported. So you'll have to actually have something newer than that to have iPad support. Also on the iPod side, you have the iPod Touch 6th generation only. That's the only one supported for iOS 11. The first thing you'll need to do is make sure that you actually have a backup of your different devices. So if you have an iPod or an iPhone that you're going to update, you need to make sure you have a backup either on iTunes, so you just plug it into iTunes and hit backup, or if you're using iCloud, just make sure you have a recent backup. So you go to settings, then you can go here at the top, go down to iCloud, scroll all the way down until you get to iCloud backup, and this will tell you the last time it backed up. Right here, it says 2:17 p.m. on 7/5. I haven't turned this iPhone on in a little while, so I'll need to back that up. And if you haven't, just make sure you've got enough battery and you're on Wi-Fi and hit backup now. Once it's backed up, you're good to go, and then you'll be safe to actually upgrade. I highly recommend using a backup to have in place just in case something fails. It doesn't often fail, but sometimes it will. The next thing you need to be aware of is how much space you're using on your iPhone. So in this case, you'll need 1 to 1.5 gigabytes usually in order to install the update. So you need that available. So you can check that under settings, go down to general, go to storage and iCloud usage, and here it tells you how much storage you have available. So in my case, I've got plenty because I have 10 gigabytes used and only 49 gigabytes available, or 49 available. Now, if I don't have enough, I can manage storage, and under manage storage, it takes a moment and tells me what's using the most amount of data. So if there's something here I don't need, I've already completed Monument Valley 2, we can go in here and just delete it right from here. Also, one of the number one things that uses your data is usually messages. And under messages, you have messages saved. Many times under the message settings, you can change everything so that it deletes anything older than, say, a month. So if we go back to settings, go down to messages. Down in messages, you can see keep messages forever. If you have forever on and you don't have a lot of storage, you may want to change that to 30 days or a year. Just keep in mind anything older than that will be deleted. So you need to keep that in mind. And if you're okay with that, change it. And you'll see it says it will delete anything older than 30 days. That will usually free up a lot of storage for most people. Once you've got your backup completed, you know that you have enough storage available to actually do the update. The next thing you need to do is make sure that your battery is at least at 50% or that you have a charger nearby. Because if it's not at 50% or more, you're not going to be able to install it until it's at 50% or more or it's plugged in. So just keep that in mind. And then once you're ready to actually install it, you'll find that update by going to settings, going to general, and then going to software update. At this time, 10.3.3 is the latest. When 11 is out, or whatever the next version is, just go ahead and hit install and it will install. Now, once it's installing, your phone will be unavailable for the time that it takes to install. So again, make sure you're not in a situation where you may need your phone right away. And if you are, wait until later to install it. It's not a big deal, but just make sure that you are aware of that. Once iOS 11 is installed on your device, you'll have all the benefits of the new features and security updates, things like that. And also, if you'd like to know what's new in iOS 11, I'll link the video in a card above and then in the description below so that you can check it out in my other video and see all the major new changes that come with iOS 11. If you haven't subscribed though, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.